talking to yourself.
Yeah, I'll be the guy that's about 10 steps ahead of you, Tony.
You always are that guy. You said the D word last week, Tony.
I know I did. Getting a little personal and crazy in his old age.
Today he said heck.
What'd you do, Tony? Write a memo?
Well, oh well. As scary as things can be, here comes Kevin Nash. And finally, fan, during that commercial break, the bodies will move out of the way.
You know, Tony, my recurring thought from this past Monday's Nitro in Rapid City was at the conclusion of the program when we all saw Hollywood Hogan with that steel chair attack Goldberg from behind. But when Goldberg turned around, all he saw in the ring was this man, Kevin Nash. And, of course, it was Goldberg exploding into the spear on Kevin Nash as Nitro went off the air.
And for once, Kevin Nash was an innocent man.
Well, in reality, if you go back during the course of that impromptu lumberjack match, as Goldberg faced Ming and members of NWO all around, it was members of the Wolfpack that really helped Goldberg momentarily there on the outside. And I guess this is how they get paid back. I know it's a case of mistaken identity, but you know a move like that, that spear, is not going to go unanswered. As a matter of fact, Big Sexy's got the microphone, and they love him here in Fargo.
Fargo, North Dakota! Wolfpack in the... Got a whole lot of red and black going on tonight. Now everybody saw what happened last Monday night. A lot of people are wondering what's on Big Sexy's mind right now when it comes to a certain gentleman named Goldberg. Bill Goldberg has been an enigma for most of us for the past year. He's a man of few words and a hell of a lot of action. So when I ran into a Monday night in Rapid City, I wasn't expecting to sit down and have a conversation. But when a man walks up to me and hands me a long neck, I figure everything's cool.
This is interesting, isn't it?
I didn't hear this.
So, Bill Goldberg, hey, I know you're a reactionary guy. You reacted to what you thought happened that night, but you got to realize one thing, Bill. I was trying to do the right thing myself. So, anytime you're on the road for a long spell, and you run out of laundry, Big Sexy's got a black and red t-shirt just for you.
Oh, boy.
Oh.
Recruiting pitch from Kevin Nash.
Boy, open invitation, it sounds like to me. Run with the Wolfpack. So to be a member of the Wolfpack, all you gotta do is pop for a long neck for this guy, huh?
I think it's deeper than that, Brain.
Yeah, I do,
Mike?
Too.
Well, I think that the long neck was just Goldberg and Kevin Nash's way of admitting that there may have just been a misunderstanding this past Monday at Nitro, but it seems like everything is kosher once again between the two.
If you were starting your own team, who would be the one man you'd pick in pro wrestling?
In pro wrestling, the one man I would pick, well, it's obvious to me and it's obvious to you. It's obvious to the people at home out there. All you gotta do is sit back and think. It can only be one guy. You know who I'm talking about, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Promotional control. consideration paid for by the following.
The all-new kitchen faucet by Moen. The only thing we didn't change is how long it lasts. Moen. Buy it for looks. Buy it for life.
What's the toughest name in school supplies? Meet Five Star. Built strong to last long.
Healthy hair starts with a healthy scalp. New Total Hair Fitness shampoos help stimulate the scalp and unclog pores for stronger, healthier hair. New Total Hair Fitness for men.
CompuServe 4.0. Better, faster, easier. For those serious about internet online, get new CompuServe 4.0. Call now.
She's an prone girl. She carried five-star first gear, so it didn't matter. One day, she met a young man just like her. From then on, they were almost inseparable. Five-star first gear from Mead. Because, you know, tough happens.
We're back, and the fans giving their own opinions here on the Thunder. As you look at this great crowd on hand in Fargo, North Dakota, we're going to bring out another member of the NWO Black and White, another NWO versus NWO matchup here. This should be a great one, guys.
And this is the first ever NWO matchup between these two. We're talking about Kevin Nash representing the Wolfpack, Kurt Hennig with Rick Rude representing the NWO Hollywood, the White and Black, although by far this is not the first time that these two veterans have met in their careers.
I'll remind you, next week, Thunder back at its regular time, and in 2 weeks, it'll be coming to you from Peoria, Illinois. That's on Wednesday, in 2 weeks, Wednesday, August 26th. Thunder, the Peoria, Illinois Civic Center, tickets to Box Office and Ticketmaster. Monday, August 24th, Nitro returns to Chicago at the United Center. Tickets to the Box Office and Ticketmaster. And on Monday, August 31st, Nitro returns to Miami in the Miami Arena. Tickets available to Box Office and all Ticketmaster locations there.
Hey, look, the mayor of Fargo made it.
You always got to rip on someone, don't you?
What do you mean? It's a good-looking guy.
You always got to diss a town or rip on someone.
Can't go through a 2 or 3 hour show without knocking on someone, can you?
I like it here in Fargo. It's a damn dare good town, then, pal. You know them dare.
Here we go.
Did you see the movie?
Yes, I did.
We need a mulcher.
All right. Bell sound should be a good one. Look at the eyes of Big Sexy.
You know, it's not often that a matchup against Goldberg can be talked about in terms of reviving your career. But if you think back to Kurt Hennig, he came off that knee surgery, immediately went into the matchups with Goldberg, and they almost served, I think, as a wake-up call. This second-generation star has really been on a roll as of late after the series with Goldberg. You look at victories over the likes of a Lex Luger, a Conan, a Steve Mongo McMichael. Hennig has really been on quite a streak as of late.
Hennig, certainly one of the most sought-after athletes in our sport. And NWO Hollywood has him. At one time, the Wolfpack thought they had him. So he was in the midst of a recruiting war as well. And, of course, his longtime personal friend out of Robbinsdale, Minnesota, back when they were a child, Rick Rude at ringside. But right now, as great as Hennig is, anyone caught in the corner against Big Sexy like that is in trouble. Look at this. Big Beal.
Oh!
That was a twisting Beal.
The power of that man.
And there's Rude looking on. You know, we talked earlier when Scott Hall faced Conan, the war that's been erupting, that's been festering, building up between the two factions. And we talked about Fall Brawl being war games. And, of course, that event is on the 13th of September. And we know one match is signed, Steiner against Steiner, Rick against Scott. But we're still waiting to see what's going to happen. The two-ring cage battleground that is war games. Hennig moved out of the way. And that could have stymied the attack from Big Sexy because it worked on the leg. He's going right to the legs. Tell you, Hennig is such a ring general, a ring strategist. He knows what to do. And you see when he saw the leg buckle that time, he went right for the knee, right for the ankle.
And especially against the big seven-footer, so smart to work on the knees and the legs. He sets it up and just cannonballs repeatedly right onto the knee and continues his offensive attack. Look at Hennig wrench it, the step over, now using the top rope.
And what he's doing here, he's taking out that left leg for one simple reason. Nash is not going to be able to powerbomb Kurt Hennig standing on one leg.
step over that time.
Smart move on the part of Hennig. You're right, taking away the jackknife powerbomb of Kevin Nash, because I think there's a question whether Curt Hennig would be able to get a wrestler the size of Kevin Nash up in that Hennigplex.
A lot of times when you go up against top superstars, you got to improvise, you got to use something different. Nash trying to shake that leg and the effects of that move off. He picks him up. Look at this. Even limping around, still have enough power just to throw him out to the top turnbuckle head first.
Snake eyes in the corner, dropping Hennig face first across the turnbuckle.
Not much steam there.
No! Nothing really, still favoring it, but that's still a load, 300 plus crashing down on your back.
Nash will send Hennig to the far side, get the big foot to the side of the head. Look at the determination on Big Sexy now.
That's going to cost Rude and Hennig.
Rude went in and whacked the referee. So you can throw this match out. I guess Rude did this to get a piece of Big Sexy.
What? What is he thinking?
I have no idea.
What is Rude thinking?
Rude's gonna...
That's what it is.
That's exactly what it is.
Scott Hall from behind.
Scott Hall from behind. It's typical NWO Hollywood. White-black tactics, and they got the advantage. As big, as bad as Big Sexy is, there's nothing he can do with these three stars pounding him like this. Nothing at all.
What a setup this was by the NWO Black and White.
I hear something. Here we go.
The fans erupt as Lex Luger slides in. Luger coming out moments before he must defend the U.S. title against Hart. So he's taking a chance here, but it sends the Black and the White away.
They got their message across to Nash.
Well, Lex really the only member of the Wolfpack here tonight left. Conan hurt with that low blow from Scott Hall that we saw moments ago. So the war continues to build, and it gets even more intense as minutes and matches go by, Mike.
Just another showdown between these two rival groups representing the New World Order.
It's time for our Master Lock of the Night. And a reminder for you to put a tough new Master Lock in your corner. It's tough under fire. Here it is, Brain.
Nash shoots Hennig into the ropes.